So the next topic is counter design as a synthesis problem. So counter design as a synthesis problem. What do you mean by synthesis problem? So if I want to design a mod 8 counter, it is somewhat simple. That is 3-bit counter. If I want to design mod 16 counter, it's simple. But if I want to design in between, if I want to design mod 3 counter, or if I want to design mod 5 counter, or if I want to design something like this, 0, 1, 3, 7, 5, 6, 2, finally 0. Then if I want to design like this, then gate level implementation is very much complicated, and it will take long process to draw the K-map and to implement this one. So better method is synthesis. Synthesis is the first step in a design process, which will try to realize the gate level implementation by gate level. It will try to realize the gate level realization by using design methodology and functions. So synthesis is the first step in the design. There are various synthesis tools are also available. Synthesis not only help to design, it also help to achieve other parameters also, different types of parameters also, like frequency, other parameters and all. So this is about synthesis. Now we'll see the synthesis design. We have to design mod 6 counter. So what is the formula for mod 6 counter to design? How many flip-flops are required? First you have to see. 2 raised to power m is equal to 6. So 2 raised to power 3 is equal to 8. That means I need 3 flip-flops. I cannot use 2 because 2 raised to power 2 is equal to 4. But my requirement is 6. So I have to compromise with 8. And design by using JK. For here you have to use excitation table here. For JK, you have to remember this one. So in synthesis method, what you will do is we have to draw the transition table where we'll write the present state. Then first we'll write the present state. Then next state, then we will draw the input, and I mean we will write the input. So here QA, QB, QC, this is the present state you have to write for 3-bit counter. So what is the combination, all combination you have to write. So you have to design mod 6. So present state is 0, what is the next state? 001. Present state is 1, what is the next state? 10. Present state is 10, what is the next state? 11. Present state is 11, what is the next state? 100. Present state is 4. Next state is 5. Present state is 5. Next state is 0. It won't go to 6. Why? Mod 6 means it will count from 0 to 5. After 5, it will return to 0. That's why 6 is not possible here. 0. Then rest of the 2 state, you have to put x, x, x. If this is done, then after that, you have to see QA and QA plus 1, and you have to write J and K. 0, 0. Present state is 0, next state is 0. What is the value of J and K? So see our table here. See the table here. 0, 0. What is the value of J and K? 0, X. So the value is 0 and X. Once again, 0, 0, 0, X. Once again, 0, 0. 0x. 0, 1. What is 0, 1? 1x. 1x. So you have to fill J, A, K, A. Similarly, you have to fill J, B, K, B. For J, B, K, B, you have to compare Q, B and Q, B plus 1. J, C, K, C, you have to compare Q, C and Q, C plus 1. And here, please remember, For this one, all are don't care conditions. After that, try to solve it by K-map. When you try to solve it by K-map, you will get J is this one, K is this one, then JB, KB, JC, KC. Then draw the three flip-flops. Draw like this. Sorry. Like this. First draw three. And in that mention which is A, which is B, which is C. Connect all the clock signals first. That is called a synchronous. Then JA, see the table here. JA is nothing but QB and QC AND gate. JB is nothing but QA bar and JB. What is JB? We'll see here. We'll go to the this one. JB is nothing but QA bar and QC. So right here. So draw an AND gate. Right QA bar and QC. Similarly, KB is equal to QC, K is equal to QC, then JC and KC is 1, connect like this. It is a very simple circuit. To draw like this is a very simple circuit. You need not to take like feedback from C and all. So just draw like this. So very simple circuit. So this is the 1. Now design mod 8 counter. So first we saw mod 6. Mod 8. 111 will leads to 000. 7, after 7, 0. So, like that, J, K, K, J, B, K, B, J, C, K, C, and K map. After that, circuit diagram. Then, mod 6 counter using design mod 6 synchronous counter using this one, design mod 6 synchronous counter. Same using SR here. It's not written here, but using S and R flip flop. For SR, you have to refer SR excitation table. After that, once again, design like same. Then draw the K map and draw the circuit diagram. Design mod 6 counter using D flip flop. So D, we won't refer this excitation table, just simple QA, QB, QC and next state. Please remember, for D, only present state, next state. There is no question of writing input once again. Present state and next state. So here mod 6, we have to design mod 6. So 6 is somewhere 5, after 5. 6, next state is 000. So later two states are XXX. Now you have to solve this one by using normal K map method. That is QA, QB, QC. QA, QB, QC. QA, QB, QC. For this one, you have to draw this one in the K map. Similarly, for this one, you have to draw this one in the K map. And simplify it and design this one, D flip-flop. This is a D, simple diagram. Similarly, mod 6, so using T. T, you have to refer excitation table. See, it's a T table is something like this. Remember this one. Once you remember this one, then QA, QB, QC, QA1, QB1, QC1, TA, TB, TC. In case of JK and SR, there will be JA, KA, JB, KB, JC, KC. In case of D, there won't be any input you have to write. In case of T, only one input, TA, TB, TC. TA, TB, TC because we are using 3-bit. So try to solve this one by using QMAP. So then draw this one. This is the method. Now design. Mod 4 irregular counter, design mod 4 irregular counter with following counting sequence using D flip flop. So now it is a irregular pattern. 0 0 it should go to 1 0, after that 1 1, after that 0 1, after that 0 0. So what you do, you write here Q क्यू ए क्यू बी और ए बी क्यू ए क्यू बी क्यू ए वन क्यू बी वन समथिंग लाइक दैट एंड यू डिजाइन दिस वन यूजिंग डी फ्लिप फ्लॉप सो हियर zero zero what is the next state for that one 10 zero one zero one what is the next state 00 10 what is the next state 11 11 what is the next state 01 so this one you have to design actually for db and da is not required here so design this one by using K map and still they have used your excitation table in this case, so you can use DB and DA and try to solve it and represent this one by using normal this one. Now, decade counter. What is decade counter? Decade counter is the one which counts 0 to 9, 10. So we have IC 7490 as a decade counter. So what is there in the 7490? You can see 7490 contains it mod 2 into 5, that is this is 2 and this is 5, so 10. That means this will work till mod 2, this will work till mod 5. If you want, you can combine. So you can use this individually as mod 2, you can use this individually as mod 5, or you can use this at till mod 10. So now you suppose if you want to use this as a mod 2, then you QA here you can see QA is the output. If you want it to count more than mod 2, then output should be connected to the input like this. Then it will work 2 into 5. So these are the reset R0 and R1. Reset is used to reset both mod 1 and mod 2 and mod 5. Here input signal we are giving. Input is nothing but clock signal. So now design. Mod 20 by using 7490. So now 7490, I am using this one. See something like this. This is unit. This will represent a unit place. This counter will represent. This counter will represent 10 place. So output of the unit will be given to input of the 10. Place tens place counter and output of here it contains 2 into 5 right output of 2 is connected to B so now here you can see in this diagram you can see this is actually 8421 this is QA QB QC QD is 8 This is connected to reset. That means when this becomes 1, this will count. Initially, this will count 0, 0, 0, 0. I mean, this is 0, 0, 0, 0. Then 1, 0, 0, 0. 1, 0, 0, 0 means 0, 0, 1. This is LSB. Truth table, you don't know. If you're confused, I will write like this. It will count 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. When... till it will count 10 1001 after 9 it gives one clock pulse to this one now this becomes 10 then once again it will count 11 12 13 14 15 16 17 18 19 that time here it becomes this becomes 1 20 That time it will reset. That is, it will count from 20. This is to implement 20 counter, mod 20 counter. design divide by 96 counter using 749 IC. 96 counter by 749 IC. So you can see here 749 0 unit place and tens place. So unit place it should be 6, 10 place it should be 9. So you see 8, 4, 2, 1. So I will connect this one and here 9, I will connect this one. When it reaches this one, this one, this one and this one, and that is connected to reset of both, it will reset. Other than that, I am giving input here. Output of the 2 is given to second one. Here output is given to second counter. Here also output of the, this contains 2 into 5. Output of the 2 is given to as input to the B. So if I call 2 is A and 5 is B, then this is input to B. So this is the implementation of 96 by 7490. So next one is the digital clock. So digital clock, one important application of the counter, digital clock. So you can see here, this contains, you can see here, this is used to implement second section, this is used to implement minute section, and this is used to implement hours section. Here it is 10 into 6, 60, 60 seconds, it will count up to 60 seconds, that is 59 seconds. This will count up to 59 minutes, after 59 minutes this becomes 1 hour. After 12 hour, this becomes, this will reset and 1 second becomes 1 in the 12 hours format. So please refer my notes and diagram. This is the 7 segment display that will display the counter. Now one more IC we have, 7492. The purpose of this this contains 2 into 6, that is it will count up to 12. This is mod 2 and this is mod 6, it can count out up to 12. Other than that, it also contains a reset button. So you can see here, reset button is also there. You can see here, reset button is there. In the diagram, it is connected something like this. This and this is connected, that means it will count up to mod 9. After 9 it will reset. So what is the use of this one? See, use of this one is this is 2 and this is 6. You can either use this as 2 or you can either use this as separately 6 or 2 into 6 or till 2 into 6, 12. This design, once again, 9. What is 9? 8, 4, 2, 1. This is connected to AND gate. When this and this becomes 1, output is 1, then that time it will reset both blocks. That is this one. Now design modulo 120 counter using mod 10 counter and 7492. You know 7492 is 12. So here you can see this is 12. This is 12 and this is 10. 12 into 10? 120. So connect in the full fledged. How it becomes full fledged? So this is clock is given here. Output of this first one is fed to the second. And output of MSB is given as input to the second IC. Then here output of the first functional block of the IC is given as input to the second. So this works like till 10, this works like 12. So it will work in the full fledged 120 counters, mod 120 counters. design mod 3 counter using synthesis method. So follow to design mod 3 counter. Mod 3 counter, it is not a 3-bit counter, it is mod 3 counter. It requires 2 flip-flops designed by using synthesis method. And design mod 10 counter. Now mod 10 counter, decade counter, simple block diagram of the decade counter, you can see here, simple block diagram of the decade counter. So 10 counter. So whenever QD and QB becomes 1, that is, we know 8, 4, 2, 1. Whenever this and this becomes 1, then it has to reset. So you can use 4 bit flip flops and one AND gate to reset. So reset is given here to all the counters. So this is reset. So next, presetable counter, refer the notes 74161, you have to refer. Presetable means it can start from particular set value, that is called as presetable counter, which has got clear signal and others. You can see here presetable counter counting 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and from there it can go at any value. So here you can see 0 to it will go 9, after that directly it will go to 15, something like this. So now verilog for mod up down counter. So up down counter design. So mod up down counter, you know, clock is required, mod signal is required, then these are the required points, required inputs. So input is clock, PL and mod, and input you define in the form of bus, output you define in the form of bus register, integer up down. Always at the negative edge of the clock. If mode is equal to 1, up down is equal to minus 1. That means it will count like a down counter. Otherwise, up down is equal to 1. That means it will work like a up counter. So now else Q is equal to Q plus up down. If parallel load, Q is equal to 0. That means if parallel load, Q is equal to D. That means whatever input is given, that is the input. Then else Q is equal to up down. For example, if the minus is used here, if this is true, then it works down. If this is true, it works is up counter. Now mod 8 counter. So this is there in the practical lab also. So clock reset output. During the negative edge of the clock or negative edge of the reset, if the reset button, then 3B0, else Q is equal to Q plus 1. So this is for mod 8 counter. So next one is the verilog code for mod 3 using JK. Mod 3, dear students, this is a very important question, please study. Here we are calling JK function, JK flip-flop function, and you can see function is written here. Please study this one. So design mod 3 counter which counts in this format. So to design mod 3 counter, I need 2 flip-flops. Then you have to write input and present state. For present state 0, what is the next state? 1. So 1, what is the next state? 2. For 2, what is the next state? 0. 0, what is the next state? 1. So like this you have to write and you have to solve this one. Sometimes they will give like this self-correcting counter 001, it should repeat. So we know this one, this we have studied self-correcting counter. So with this we have completed counter chapter also. Thank you.